Oh yeah, you don't shout like that in the Lord to move without the music. Come on, open up your mouth and shout unto God. Shout unto God. Come on, shout unto God. Like what you're praying for is already done. Shout unto God. Like what you've been praying for is already done. Shout. Shout. Look at somebody and tell them, my God is a champion, and he's undefeated, and his record won't be broken today. Find somebody else and tell them, my God is a champion, and he's undefeated, and his record won't be broken. You need to tell somebody else, tell them, my God is a champion, he's undefeated, and his record won't be broken. God gave me that Wednesday night, and I've been chanting it every day. I don't care what kind of devil is staring you in the face. Look back at the devil and tell him, my God is a champion. He's undefeated, and his record won't be broken. Oh, I feel an old saint's anointing. I feel an old saint's anointing. You know, we young folk got the more neurons, but I hear some old folk. My God is a champion. He's undefeated, and his record won't be broken. Y'all don't. Yeah. You should have hung around your grandmama long enough to know how the old folk used to. My God. Champion. Champion. They didn't say champion. All right, I done lost y'all. Let's look at somebody and whisper, tell them, my God is a champion. Tell him, he's undefeated, and his record won't be broken. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Whisper in somebody's ear and tell them, my God is a champion. He's undefeated, and his record won't be broken. Oh, you ought to tell somebody, my God is a champion. He's undefeated, and his record won't be broken. Hallelujah. But what y'all got to understand, the Bible says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Then he says we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities. But then if you jump back to the Old Testament, he tells old Jehoshaphat, he said the battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. So what that means is God is the champion. He's got to do all the fighting, but we get the victory. I said God is the champion. He's in the fight, but we get the victory. That seemed like a pretty good deal. Look at your neighbor, tell him, now you ought to get up off your rusted dust and give God some praise. Because God gonna give you victory for nothing. He's the champion. He's got to do all the fighting, and you get the victory. Look at somebody, why are you sitting now? Why are you looking crazy now? Whatever it is you're going through, God's got it. He's the champion. He's the warrior. You get the victory. Wouldn't show up to a fight where the enemy is already defeated. Tell your neighbor, all you gotta do is just show up, cause your enemy is already defeated. Oh, somebody. said he may not come when you want him, but he's always, 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 always. So I don't know about y'all, but I thank God for the victory and the lesson. Because if God gave me victory when I wanted it, I wouldn't have learned the lesson. I would have just had a temporary victory. But anybody had to suffer a little while, look at your neighbor and say, I done been through a little something. That's why I'm praising him like I'm praising him right now. Because I'm not just thanking God for victory, but I'm also thanking him for wisdom. See, I got the victory and the lesson. See, because when you get victory plus the lesson, it means you don't have to go back through that no more. Some of y'all can't praise him because you just got out of it and you're scared that you're going to have to go back through it again. But the Bible said, after you have suffered a little while. Now look at somebody and tell them, say, now we ain't trying to fool you into praise because you're going to suffer a little bit. Tell somebody, after you have suffered a little while. You know, God's getting ready to do something today because there's too many wheelchairs and walkers coming in here. He ain't preached in two Sundays. Well, what I believe is real preachers don't have to preach every Sunday because the word is so potent it'll carry the folk a little while. And sometimes you got to preach a word past the limit and then give God time to make it manifest in their lives. I don't want to keep dumping food on the table every day and you ain't ate what I prepared yesterday. Hallelujah. Folk that got victory, that's what we do. You don't tell somebody, I spent enough time crying and being sad and depressed and being confused. But you ought to tell somebody, since the Lord came into my life, that's been a great change. That's been a great change in me. Come on, tell somebody, I'm happy. Hallelujah. His name is Jesus. The righteous Son of God, he's the lily of the valley, he's the bright and morning star. His name is Jesus, he's my everything. I am happy just to know that I'm his child. Why are you happy? Because his name is Jesus, the righteous Son of God.
Welcome to Jericho.
Everybody,
face the Lord.
We got to rejoice. Welcome.